This is a job I did like back in 2010. I did all the fascia and the soffit on this house, and whatever needed to be replaced as far as the exterior trim went. Also did the gutters. That face board there, I made that rib with a Tapco brake buddy. That's a great tool. That eliminates any kind of oil cans you'd have and say in a coil that wasn't that great, or you know, it just eliminates a lot of oil canning. A lot of times, even if your soffit or your fascia is perfectly straight, you'll still get an oil can if you can't put a lip on top. In this case, I slid underneath a piece of roof edging, and I was glad to do it. But in order to eliminate the oil canning, I put that brake ready rib. That rib I've been using, I use it every job I do as far as aluminum trim work. I kind of grew up in this business, and years ago we didn't have that rib roll former. Anyway, some other things I did here at this job, besides all the soffit and fascia, put the windows in, cap these garage doors, and this was something I did with the brake buddy too. I had this center post here, and I put two ribs in here as well, and these colonial doors, I guess you call them, with the little chips on top, the chipped corners. Also, what was done here was this soffit and fascia. All the soffit is ventilated, and behind that gutter, I put that up. That's also has a brake buddy roll formed edge, which is pretty good. It kind of throws it out of whack a little bit, but it's not bad as far as the gutter sitting flat on the roof. It's also able to make that little transition there from the gutter to the downspout going down there. Some other things I did on this job. Was this porch is like 12 or 13 feet. And if you look close, there's no seam in this header. But it does have the brake buddy in the middle. And so I remember doing this job, even with the brake buddy roll formed rib I put in there, I did get a little bit of oil canning back in this corner. So before I put this soffit J-channel up, which I make that on the job as well, I was able to take my chisel. I just made a small indentation before I put this soffit channel up. I made a small indentation with a chisel, an old Dell chisel, and I made a ridge above, behind that channel, and that took the oil can out. I had a little oil can happening from above this formed rib above it, so I was able to get that out. So kind of proud of this job, because only a couple jobs I've ever done this without the with the seamless, unless you had a 14-foot break, that's the only way you could do that. And of course this post, I always put these posts on in this fashion. This is like a 3 3/8, a 3 5/8, 3 3/8, and of course I put like an inch or a 3/4 bend here. I do the face, it's 3 5/8 usually, and then another 1 inch back here. When I cut those, I always make sure the way they get cut on the break and broke off is I have there's just a burr left, but the burr goes into my material. It doesn't go out. So I'll cut and break off the unfinished side. Okay, well, thanks for stopping by.